Welcome back to the Small Business Show. You know, I'm really looking forward to actually chatting with you.
With me?
Yes.
Am I a guest on your show?
No, we're a guest on our own show, right?
Hi, Steve. It's been a ball. When we came up with the idea of the Small Business Show a couple of years ago, we had no idea where it would go, did we?
No. And, you know, I think we took a lot of time looking at the first season to really see what we did that we liked, maybe some things to change, and I think we've really made some good improvements this
year.
Well,
I like it better that we're sitting closer together, because now I can keep
I got a couple bruises here already.
No, seriously, so last year we had some amazing guests, but we've made some changes this year, haven't we?
Yeah, I think one of the things we picked up, and certainly maybe more subconsciously with me, is the nature of our guests. We had a lot of gentlemen on our show last year, but we didn't bring enough women into the show.
It's not that we didn't bring the women in. Unfortunately, the women were not available.
Okay.
That was it. Because, like I say, we really, really tried, but I think it was very last minute. And this year, we've got a really nice, balance of men
absolutely,
and women.
Absolutely. And, you know, I think the countering perspectives, too, you know, when we have, you know, a gentleman and a lady talking about something, it gives perspective that we wouldn't necessarily get from what we were doing last year. I think the other thing I like is being on the set.
And
certainly it just is a little more conducive and being able to change up the format that we're using this year.
So one of my favorite things is when we are bringing in a panel of three people, because that way we're going to get different perspectives on different topics.
I think though that when we're looking at the topics, we're really trying to think more than just small business. We're trying to look at all of the success stories. We're trying to balance that with people in different industries. We're trying to look at it from a joint perspective, collective perspective, instead of just one-on-one. And certainly the supportive services that are available for businesses. Rounding out all that whole infrastructure for small business has been really important.
Well, you know, my favorite thing is the challenges that people have in business, big or small. And I like to be controversial, so I want to bring those challenges out so that basically we can be aware of them and everybody can help each other.
Well, I think that's something you said is it's not enough. People aren't bringing it out. And I think by being a bit of a vocal point and being able to talk about it on television and the various entities that we use it, it's important to bring that out because it's too silent and it's so important. It's like you take women in IT, right? There's just not enough and there's not enough support and there's not enough people talking about it.
And the trades, women in trades, so those are two of the topics we'll be touching on. The other thing I like about being in the studio is I just feel like we were born to be here, don't you? Like, we just fit into these chairs really nicely.
They're more comfortable.
They are very comfortable. I think the show, the Small Business Show, is needed in the community for the people who cannot get to the seminars, the conferences. They can reach people through us, can't they?
You know, in our various times of being out and talking to different people and presenting and stuff, I've heard that over and over. And when you came up with that idea a couple years ago to say, why isn't there something on television? It just went from there and it's become very, very important. And I hear a lot of people saying, thank you for bringing it to TV.
Oh, that's so sweet. That's lovely.
But it just makes you feel like you're doing something good.
But we are, and you know why it works with you and I. You're a financial guy, aren't you?
Yes.
And I'm more of the motivational kind of person. But it really works because we have different perspectives.
I think there needs to be that balance and that chemistry. I think somebody's even said it to me, and you know, certainly from a lot of guests, is that the chemistry we bring to the set is just encouraging and it's contagious.
It is. And the thing is, it's like a marriage, but it's not the marriage where we have to cook each other meals and do things.
No, we can go home at the end of the day.
And I can stop hitting you.
I don't know about that.
No, I'm really enjoying it. Again, the Small Business Show isn't necessarily just for small businesses.
No.
It's for entrepreneurs, startups, large businesses.
Well, we've even talked about children, like teenagers trying to figure out where they want to go, but even bringing like the skill sets into the school and stuff like that. It's, I think, becoming a bigger and bigger picture as we're going forward in terms of doing the show and the people we're talking to. It's just opened our eyes to a lot of different things.
I tell you what, I've got so many more guests lined up, and you've got all the ideas for the guests you've got lined up, and I don't think we can ever really bring all the guests. Like, we need like a show every day, don't we? Really?
Right.
We're not going to do a show.
I was going to say.
but can you imagine all the guests we could get on the show? It'd be amazing, wouldn't it?
Do you know what's also is when you get people asking asking to be on the show, right? I think that just speaks to the fact, I mean, there's personal reasons people want to do that, but it just speaks to the, obviously, that it's resonating with people, right? And they want that opportunity, So
again, just very quickly, Steve, you've got lots of experience in the financial sector, mm-hmm. but you're one of those people that was able to rebrand with a little bit of help, mm-hmm. and you market yourself and do all the sales. You didn't all have it handed on a plate, did you?
No, and I think any small business person has to realize if they don't, it's hard work. Mm-hmm. And in the beginning, it's continuous and it's almost all day, mm-hmm. and it's, you got it. And if you can't commit to that, then you're going to have a challenge making a success of it, right? Mm-hmm. I know you keep talking about a statistic about how long it takes for a small business to actually become successful.
Yeah.
And it's not easy, and people have to learn that it's a long process.
It used to be
process.
5 years, and I depend on the business. It could be 6, 7, 8, or 10.
Yeah.
Well, as you know, I'm a workaholic. And basically, I love my work. I do it all the time. I wouldn't be doing what I do if I didn't love it. And I think if you're going to start making excuses about why you don't want to be in small business, you shouldn't be in small business. Or you shouldn't work for a large corporation either. You should do something you really enjoy. It's not about the money.
Well, I've had that discussion with you before about whether somebody's in a business or in a hobby, right? They've got to understand, to be in a business, it's not just what you're doing directly. It's all of that support infrastructure, the marketing, the administration, the finances. People need to understand that it's really a strong commitment, and they need to realize that that's going to bring them down sometimes.
So,
but if they've got the drive, hopefully that will get them there.
What do you think we could share with our viewers, a couple of tips from you and myself about... First of all, I think my first tip would be, if you're really, really thinking about starting a small business, I would plan it ahead of time, every step of the way, the finances, whether you need a standalone, you know, store or something like that. And also, are your family happy about it? I mean, that's one tip about, you know, planning ahead.
I think that's something that needs to be really, really important in terms of people deciding to go into business, is how does the family factor into that,
yeah.
right? But I think people also have to realize that they don't have to learn everything themselves by trying to find the resource. There's a lot of support. There's a lot of mechanisms by which they can bring that information to bear. We talk about mentors, for example, mm-hmm. right? They're not doing the work for you, but they're giving you guidance and maybe how to get to where you need to be.
But I mean, you could probably give us a financial tip. Like, I know for a fact I started two businesses with no money at all, no budget. What kind of business do you think you'd start where you do need a financial backer, or you need a loan from the bank?
Well, I think it depends on what you want to bring to market, right? So you talk about IT and you talk about startups. There's a strong, and that's the biggest part with a lot of startups, is trying to find that venture capital, trying to find that financial backer.
So they
right?
would need some money to start.
Absolutely,
off.
Because there's a lot of research, there's a lot of development, there's a lot of people working on that, right? But I think it doesn't matter what business you're in, you have to consciously understand and learn what's it going to take financially to get forward in that business.
But some businesses can start with just, say, a laptop, mm-hmm. a little space in the house, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
And then maybe hone the business before they start spending lots of money. Because did you know, a lot of small businesses only stay in business a year, and then they give up for lots of reasons. So why spend a lot of money or get a bank loan if you're not going to be following
through? Well, you're not going to get a bank loan, right? I mean, the only banks are going to lend to people that don't need the money, right? So, but you got to realize, how much do you have available,
yeah.
right? And you have to make sure that you're staying within the constraints of your financial ability, right? Mm-hmm. And you talk about what you just mentioned, about a year, and then people are having issues. It's because they overextend themselves.
Yeah.
It's because they get focused on so many other things other than trying to find their market and find sales.
You know, my biggest beef, if you don't try and build some sort of brand, people are not going to treat you seriously in the beginning. Secondly, networking's not all about fun and sales. Networking's about building those relationships.
Mm-hmm.
And people poo-hoo networking, and look where it got us.
And I don't understand that concept of boo, because you meet so many people, right? It's not just connecting for sales. It's connecting for people who can help you in your business. Even competitors, right?
Mm-hmm.
You got to learn about them. And what's a great way to have a conversation and a networking function, right?
Yeah.
It's all about the connectability. It's all about the relationships. And that's a very strong conduit for doing that.
And don't join a networking organization until you know if you're a fit for it, they can help you. And also invest your time, not just your money.
You know, I think people need to be very conscious of the use of their time, too. And I think you could see in a lot of people, they don't get their priorities right,
no.
right? They spend so many things doing things that aren't necessarily getting them to where they're actually engaging with the clients, they're performing or providing a product, and then they're getting revenue from it,
yeah.
right? You can spend a lot of time designing fancy brochures or going out and having, well, I do a lot of coffees, but going out, but you've got to have a reason for doing it, right?
Yeah.
And a lot of people don't really think about that from the planning side, as you mentioned
I've
earlier.
I've got another thing as well. Don't spend a lot of money on your marketing brochures. in the early days, but if you're going to do it, measure the success of it. In some way, have a code on there so you know where they've gone, who's mm-hmm. coming back to you. Mm-hmm. Another thing is, if you're going to do online and you're going to pay for online Facebook, measure if it's been successful. Don't blame Facebook or the brochures if it didn't work, because did you research what marketing would work for your company? People are not aware they've got to do all these things, and this is where we're helping them.
But I think they don't realize what they don't need to do as well. You talk about brochures, you know, and I say this to people, they go out and spend a lot of money on marketing material, but they have no reason to understand why they're doing it, how they're using it, or what response they're getting. Yeah. So you talk about metrics. Metrics is so important. So start small and really gauge where you're getting the best impact and you're getting a response from it. Right?
Why not use the free resources and start telling your stories on Facebook or Twitter or mm-hmm. LinkedIn? That costs nothing. You don't have to dive in and spend lots of money. And then what you do, say if I post something and then you like it, then I start a conversation with you. It's so simple.
Well, I'd like to think it's simple, but you know, I think the important point is there's a lot of online resources and there's a lot of ways of doing things that aren't as expensive as you think they are, right? So I think people need to spend some time, and that's about education, right?
Mm-hmm. Education.
They need to be always learning. I think that's so important too. So, you know, for intensive purposes, we got a lot to talk about on the Small Business Show.
We're looking forward
to it. We could do this and we could continue on, but you know what? We have to take a break and we'll be right back on the Small Business Show.
This program is brought to you by the following sponsors.
For some people, debt is a growing concern, but solving your debt problems has never been easier.
Contact Allison Lopez or myself, Julie Medeiros, and we can show you how easy it really is. Debt consolidation and mortgage refinancing can mean a fresh start to life.